is Paul McKenna for PT Boxing in association with the EsNews with me. Hosea Burton, how are you, mate? Okay?
Alright, thanks,
mate. Good stuff. Been getting some work in today, obviously. Your next fight, December the 10th, defending the British title against Frank Buglioni. Everything there going well? Camp going well up to now?
Everything's going as good as it can be. Just getting some good sparring in now.
Yeah.
Everything is as expected.
Looking forward to the fight.
Yeah, it's a fight I'm looking forward to. It's a bit of a big name. You've got a big mouth yourself, so it should be a good fight.
Yeah, obviously, it's. Would you say the biggest name up to date in your career, personally?
He's the biggest name, but is he the best fighter? No. But yeah, he's the biggest name.
Okay. I know there is a little bit of. There is a little bit of kneel in the fight. Does that help in the fact that it gives it that extra little bit of motivation or that extra little bit of spite for you to?
I'm motivating for anybody, but it doesn't hurt any. I'm motivated if I can fight anybody. So just because he's got a bit of big man's words, doesn't bother me at all.
Obviously, I had a good year, 2016. I believe 4 wins out of 4 stoppages as well. So. It's obviously you got your hands on that British title and looking successfully defending it in December. So, as you say, he is regardless of whether he'd be the best fighter you fight up to now or not. He's a big name. People do know Buglioni, isn't there? There's certain people that are backing Buglioni to win the fight. So it's down to you to go out there and
people
show.
People backing him all work for his dad, on the scaffolding. So they're the only ones who's backing him. Anybody who knows about boxing is backing me. You can't go into work. Scaffolding saying, oh yeah, fancy Burton to knock Buglioni out.
Yeah.
Because you're going to lose your job, aren't you?
Well, yeah, possibly. I was checking, I was having a little look at someone tweeted last night, I think the bookies have got you like a 1-3 on favourite, so they believe you're the favourite in the fight, obviously you're confident, so looking to not just go out there and get the win, though, looking on putting a statement on.
I'm just looking to get the win, I look to get the win on any opponent, just how it comes. I'm not too bothered if I knock him out or if he goes the distance, which I do think I will knock him out because I think he's a bit too easy to catch. So yeah, knockout could be on the cards.
What do you make of Buglioni's career up to date? Obviously he's won the same amount as you but lost.
He's a great salesman. He's a great salesman. His career is based on how good he can sell tickets. You know he's fought for a world title, but he can also sell 1,000 tickets. Would he have fought for a world title if he could sell 200 tickets? No, he wouldn't have.
Do you think that's what sort of carrying him through?
Listen, Frank Warren's not a stupid man. Frank Warren got every penny he could out of Buglioni for selling tickets, getting easy enough world title chance. And he failed. He got knocked out by a middleweight.
Kaminsky.
And then he had a grueler with what's his name?
Was it Markham? Lee Markham.
Yeah, Lee Markham. Had a grueler with him, and then got beat up off a natural middleweight again. With Chudnoff. He's a small super middleweight.
Do you think the fact that it's at light heavyweight could play a big factor in the fight?
He cannot beat me at light heavyweight. He cannot beat me at top and bottom of it. Maybe if I was to go down to super middleweight where I can't, I can't make super middleweight, it might be a harder fight, but I am a natural light heavyweight. He's not.
Yeah.
He's a failure at super middleweight, so he's thought give it a go at light heavy.
Providing everything goes well December the 10th, you'll get some good recognition for obviously beating Buglioni, defending the British title for the first time. Is the 3 defences something that you'd like to do in 2017?
Yeah, I'd love to win it outright, keep that belt. Hopefully everything goes well on this fight. I'll give Tony Dodson a chance because we was lined up to fight once before. He had an unfortunate injury.
Yeah.
And I don't mind him. I think he's not a bad man.
That was scheduled to be on the Bellew.
Yeah, that was meant to be on the Bellew on the card, so. He's not done nothing to piss me off, so we can give him another shot.
Yeah, so that's the plan. Beat Buglioni, defend for the second time against Dodson, get one last one in and then move on then.
That's it, move on.
That's it, mate. Well, on that note, I'm sure the fans are looking forward to December the 10th. I'm sure you're looking forward to it. I know I am. So it's going to be an interesting fight. Just been speaking to Joe, and he said, and I agree with it 100%, that
you being a commentator, I mean a fucking cameraman, yeah. interview, wherever you are, who do you think will win the fight?
Honest opinion, I think you only get stopped. No, I'm joking. Honest opinion, I think, I don't know whether it'll go, I think you might beat him on points.
I might beat him on points.
Yeah, I don't, maybe a late stoppage or points, in my that's just my opinion. But
would you be shocked if I'd done him in two?
I wouldn't say shocked.
Yeah. Just have a late stoppage.
I still wouldn't be shocked, because it's boxing, anything can happen, but I can't see it going early personally. But why would you be shocked if you'd done him in two?
I wouldn't be shocked, no.
No?
I wouldn't
be shocked at all. Well, let's see. If you do him in two, I'll speak to you after, and we'll see what happens.
Alright.
Alright, mate, well listen, I'm sure we'll catch up with you December 10th. Best of luck, and we'll catch up with you soon.